Today we are going to discuss about FOL, that is first order logic. So it is more expressive than propositional logic. So the operators that we use in FOL are AND, that is conjunction, disjunction, that is OR, AND, OR, implication, double implication, negation. These are also used in propositional logic. But the additional thing that FOL has is quantifiers, that is universal quantifier and existential quantifier. So universal, it means whenever we have in statement we have all or something like that, and in existential we have words like some people or some, that's where we use the quantifier existential. We'll understand it when the examples come. So FOL is in the form P bracket X, where P is predicate, X is subject. Predicate, what is predicate basically? It is part of a sentence containing a verb, basically, or stating something about the subject attribute. So for example, now when I have an example, for example, John is tall. Now, John is what? John is going to be our subject, the main person of this. So John will be our subject, and an attribute, that is something that is going to state about a subject, is what? Tall. So tall bracket John. Isn't this and this the same form? P, where tall is our predicate and John is our subject. Let's go ahead and see some more examples. So our next example is all happy people smile. Now since we have the word all, we are going to use universal quantifier. For all X, people X. What do you mean by people X? So it basically means we are storing people in X. So X means people, and what? And happy people. So happy is what? Happy is sort of an attribute, that people are happy. So similar to John is tall, so hence we write away happy people, and all happy people smile. So this implies that smile is what? A predicate. And I also said that predicate is a part of a sentence containing a verb. So what is the verb over here? Smile. Basically something that person is doing, or some relation, that's what a predicate is. Hence we write smile. And who smiles? X. And we should remember one thing, that in most of the cases wherever we have universal quantifier we use implication, just like this, and wherever we have existential quantifier we use conjunction, that is AND. Now our next example is all gorillas are black. Now since I have written all, so for all X we store gorilla in X, and it implies that what? They are black bracket X. I think this was simple, pretty easy. Now our next example is some gorillas are black. So here what we do is we use existential, because of the word some, existential X, gorillas X, we store gorillas in X, and what? These X are black. And we use conjunction. Now we will see few examples. We are going to solve little tougher ones. Let's do it. So our first question is, an offspring of a horse is a horse. Now what is the subject over here? Horse. So we will write, for all X we will store horse in X. Okay. And then we are going to use a predicate, that is offspring, because offspring is what? It is sort of a relation, and hence that will become our predicate. And offspring y comma x. So we can also consider predicate as a function, because what is when I write offspring y comma x, it means y is an offspring of x. So it implies that horse y. So basically what it means is, for all X an offspring, y is an offspring of what? Horse. Now this will imply what is y? This will imply what is y? We'll come to know here. So this implies that horse is y. This is how we solve FOL.